When we talk about wireless audio in production, we often just say RF, which stands for radio frequencies. Now, these exist far higher in the frequency spectrum than what we humans can actually hear, but the more we use wireless technology in society, like with smartphones, the more crowded this bandwidth is becoming. First in this video, we look at the UHF range, which stands for ultra high frequencies. Then we discuss intermodulation, which occurs when we broadcast multiple frequencies. And we see how to avoid intermodulation by using banks or groups which contain compatible sets of frequencies. Our human hearing ranges from about 20 hertz to 20 kilohertz, or 20,000 hertz. As you get older, you start to lose some of the higher stuff, especially with exposure to high decibel levels, but this is the frequency range we usually think about in audio. But radio frequencies are much higher, and we typically operate in the UHF range, which stands for ultra-high frequencies, which are measured in megahertz. That's millions of cycles per second, so obviously it's way above anything we can actually hear. Now, really the only problem with operating in this range is that we are competing with TV stations and police stations who use a bunch of radios and other wireless audio systems, and it can be tough to find clean frequencies in dense urban areas. Plus, huge chunks of the UHF spectrum have been auctioned off to mobile phone carriers, so our legal operating bandwidth does shrink from time to time, and it's totally different depending on where you are in the world. And if we do get interference from an external source who's transmitting information on the same frequencies that we are, we can start to hear some dropouts. Now, in this case, we can switch both our transmitter and receiver to a clean frequency and hopefully avoid any further RF hits. However, as soon as we are operating more than one wireless system and transmitting on two or more frequencies, we have to worry about intermodulation. This is when multiple radio frequencies interact to create additional unwanted frequencies and is caused by the non-linearity of RF circuitry, especially when we add too much gain in our antenna system. Almost all wireless systems have some degree of intermodulation, even though if we are using best practices, this should be essentially inaudible. But this digital 6000 system is actually intermodulation free, but it does let us fit way more channels in less bandwidth or have an increased density. But for the vast majority of RF systems, the good news is that intermodulation is predictable and we can use an equation to predict exactly where it occurs. Now, this equation is a little complex and really beyond the scope of this course. And obviously in live music, we don't have time to sit down and try to do an equation at a show. So most wireless systems come with preset banks of frequencies or groups of frequencies if you're using a Shure system that we can use at the same time and avoid intermodulation. So the actual number of banks and the number of available frequencies in each bank changes depending on your location. And actually the 6000 system has different models made for various regions of the globe that operate in the correct frequency range for each region. So this one is made to operate here in the US and it has a bunch of banks and a bunch of frequencies that all work here in this country. Now just choosing frequencies in the same bank works great for operating a few systems, but professionals who run a ton of wireless simultaneously need to have a clearer picture of the full RF spectrum in real time. So we can actually use measurement software on a computer, which gives us a lot more information to work with. And we can actually plug a computer via Ethernet straight into these digital 6000 systems and get access to all the information they have. Plus, there are a bunch of companies that make specialized tools for RF technicians. Some of these can get very specialized and very advanced, but when we're in a really crowded wireless environment, like at a huge music festival, having these advanced options can be a lifesaver. In this video, we looked at UHF, which stands for ultra high frequencies. We discussed intermodulation, which occurs when we broadcast multiple frequencies, and we covered banks or groups, which contain compatible sets of frequencies.